Hello everyone, welcome back to another video. In today's video, I am going to be showing you how to make this using your PC. For this tutorial, we will need Roblox Studio with load character and animation editor plugins. We will also need Blender and any other photo editing software like Photoshop and GIMP. I will be using PixArt, but you can use any other software. Anyways, that's enough for the intro. Let's get on to the video. Open any browser and go to roblox.com/create. Then click manage my experiences or go to roblox.com. Then click on create. Once you are here, click on create new experience. Then download Roblox Studio. Most of you probably have it. You can find it by searching it in the taskbar. But if you didn't have it, now you do. Once you have downloaded or updated your Roblox Studio, you're gonna need to go ahead and log into your Roblox account. Once you have logged in, you're going to click on Classic Blaze Plate. Once this is loaded up, you can right click to view the camera around and press WASD to move. Now we need to do some settings here. So first go to view on top, then make sure your toolbox and explorer are enabled. Then go to model and change move and rotate both to 0 degrees. Basically, toolbox is where you're going to get all the backgrounds, faces, etc. And explorer tab is to view and select everything you have placed. Now before we move any further, we are going to be installing the plugins. So you will see two links in the description. Just click them and then you're going to be seeing this. Just click the install button and it's going to install the plugins for you. And that's it, you have the plugins installed. Now let's continue. Come back to Roblox Studio and click on plugins, then load character. Now type your Roblox username here. Then spawn R15 as it's way better than R6. First I like to change my face. So go to toolbox, then images and drag any face to your character. Now look at the explorer tab, click on your character name, then that arrow, scroll down until you find head and then click on it and look for face and then right click and click delete or just simply press delete on your keyboard to delete it. There are just way too many faces to choose from. I will just choose a background so it looks better. Now you can see how dark this thing is. So we can do is add a light here. So search for light and drag it to the room. Okay, so I'm going to be searching light here, and let's wait. Okay, now there is a lot of light, but I just like to go with the ceiling light, and let's drag it to the model. Now as you can see, it's actually hidden behind the monitor, so I'm just going to take it and put it to the top. Okay, now that looks good. Once that is done, I'm just going to rotate my character. So click on your character, then go to model, and then click rotate. Now you can use these green, red, blue lines to rotate your character. And like by mistake, if you do anything wrong, you can press Ctrl plus Z to get back to the previous stage. Click Ctrl plus Y to redo the thing. Okay, I think that looks good. Now I'm just going to press select again and move it to the top of the chair. Okay, now go to plugins. Then click animation editor. Make sure you don't choose the right one. But anyways, once you choose the animation editor, press your character, then click select. And then now you can click on your parts and move it according to your choice. So for example, I just pressed my legs and now I can actually move it. So I'm just going to make it so that it looks like my character is sitting on the chair. You can move basically any part of your body. And if you chose R6, it might not be possible to do all the parts. So that's why we chose R15. Anyways, I'm just going to speed this part. Once you are done, go to model and then anchor your character. If you cannot click it, then see in the Explorer tab and press your username. Once you do that, you should be able to press the anchor button. Now as you can see, this is how I made it. And then I'm just going to click on my character and move it to the chair. You can also click the move button on the top. Now that's all with the Roblox Studio. Now we are going to just export this model. So first, go ahead and go to Explorer tab, then look for base plate. Click on it, then press delete on your keyboard to delete it. Then press Ctrl and select your username, light and model and everything you just took. Then right click and click group. Once you do that, you are basically done. Just right click on your model and press export selection. And I like to save it to a different folder, but you can save it anywhere. It might could take a while to save it if your PC have low hardware, but it won't take that long. Next, we will be needing Blender 2.79b version because it's the easiest. So let's search Blender here. And also, if you don't have it, I'm just going to show you how to do it. So first, go to your browser. Also, you can close your Roblox Studio now. So go to your browser and search Blender 2.79B. And then press the first link which appears. And you can see the download Blender 2.79B old written there. Just press it and it's just going to download your Blender. Once the download is completed, just open it and complete the setup and you should have Blender installed. After you complete the setup, just open Blender, then press anywhere on the screen to remove that. Then press X and hit delete to delete the cube. Then choose cycle render on top. Then we are going to import the model which we just made. So go to file, import, and then choose the wavefront and then find the file which you just exported. Make sure you open the .obj file and not the .mtl one, because we are going to be needing the .obj one. Now in order to move, you are going to need to click Shift plus F on your keyboard, then WASD to move forward, backward, right and left. And you can also use your mouse to look around, and you can press Shift plus WASD to move faster. Now once you are near your model, you are just gonna click on 0 on your keyboard. So press 0 on your keyboard. And once you press 0 on your keyboard, this is going to happen. And you're just gonna click Shift plus F again to move. You can see we are now back to the place. Now I am just going to choose my device to GPU compute. If you have a GPU, you can also do that and choose the frame rate to 60 fps. Now also, if you do anything by mistake wrong in Blender, you can press. Now just take that much part which you're going to need to have in the thumbnail. Now once you are satisfied with it, just click on the circle down in the bottom and choose render there. That's gonna bring all the colors instead of bag. And if your PC starts to lag, you can choose material or you can even go back to the default one. Now click on that thing, then choose ambient occlusion and choose the color that's basically going to be your lighting. So I'm just going to choose a little bit of this color here, little white type. And now that looks good. Now just go back and choose rendered there. This is basically how your project is going to look like once it's exported. Now press F12 on your keyboard and it's just going to start rendering your image. Now it's going to be depending upon your PC. If it's good, then it's going to take almost no time. Now once your Blender image is rendered, you're gonna click on the image in the bottom and click save as image. Then choose wherever you want to save it. So I save it in Blender exports folder. Once you find the folder, just press save as image. And you can also rename it. And now I'm just going to show you how it looks finally. So this is how it looks, but this is not yet the final product. We are going to edit it in our photo editing software. I'm just used to PixArt, so I'm just gonna use that, but you can use Photoshop or any other software which you use. Some free alternatives to Photoshop are Photopea and Glimp. but you can also use PicsArt like I'm just going to show you. So first I'm just going to send this image to my phone. So I'm going to connect it to my PC. Now I'm going to go to my tablet and then to SD card, and I've made a separate folder for it. So I'm just going to drag it and that's it. Now that we are in our phone, we are just going to open PicsArt. I am using the paid version of PicsArt, but you can also use the free version. Now once PicsArt is loaded, click on the plus icon, then choose edit a photo. And choose the image which we just put into our phone. Just to make sure it's in 16:9 ratio, we are just going to click on tools and then crop and just press YouTube there. So it's just going to crop it into 16:9 ratio, which is basically the YouTube's thumbnail size. Now I'm just going to add some text. So press the text button on the bottom. And I'm just going to write here make thumbnail / GFX. Now I'm going to put it to the top hand side, and then I'm just going to change the font to the luckiest guy one, because this is the one which I use. You can use any other one. Now I'm going to change the color to yellowish type. And then add some stroke with full. Actually, let's change the color to green. And then increase the pen to -1. And make the size a little bigger. I'm also going to write full thumbnail tutorial there. Now I'm going to change the pen to 0% for this. Now that looks good. Now I'm going to put it beneath the make thumbnail / GFX one. So that looks almost perfect. Now I'm going to change the color of this. Now I'm going to add some pictures. I also have a full tutorial on how to use PicsArt, so I'm just going to link it in the description so you can watch it.
Swear I won't forget this, why do I regret this? In my mind reckless, thoughts are feeling endless. Sitting up I'm breathless, anxiety's infectious. I feel so defenseless, betrayed and embarrassed. I hate being open, I hate being broken. I feel like an ocean filled up with emotion. Anger ain't a potion, rub it on like lotion. I can feel it soaking, reopen, the scars have awoken. I can't move on till I let go. I feel so lost, never at home. Need to be strong, every breath hold. Cause I can't move on till I let go. I can't move on till I let go. I feel so lost, never at home. Need to be strong, every breath hold. Cause I can't move on till I let go.
The pain makes it real. I don't wanna feel. I just wanna kill the bad things.
on till I let go. I feel so lost, never at home. Need to be strong, every breath hold. Cause I can't move on till I let go. I can't move on till I let go. I feel so lost, never at home. Need to be strong, every breath hold. Cause I can't move on till I let go. Of change, been through a lot of pain. Some things are not the same as they were a year ago, but all will be okay. I move on each and every day. The past is where it stays, way back a year ago. I've changed for the better this time. I thought I would never be fine. I strive just to say I'm alright. And for the first time in a long time, I'm alright. I've seen a lot of change, been through a lot of pain. Some things are not the same as they were a year ago, but all will be okay. I move on each and every day. The past is where it stays, way back a year ago.
As you can see, this is how the final product looks like, and you can press the download button on the top to save it to your gallery. And that's enough for today's video. Thank you for watching. Make sure to like, share and subscribe.
Knows, but I'ma choose what's right and take what comes and goes, and ain't no one in life holding me back no more. I've seen a lot of change, been through a lot of pain. Some things are not the same as they were a year ago, but all will be okay.